Joe DeRosa is going to be filming a, recording a comedy CD at the Stress Factory tonight and tomorrow.
Yes,
filming
sir.
The whole time, recording the whole time.
Yeah, taping two shows tonight, two tomorrow.
Is it true that fucking Bobo's warming up for you?
I'm supposed to give him a guest spot tonight, but this. I just said that to get the fans to come out. If they're not going to come in.
Yeah, welcome.
You have a second doubt?
He shut up. He's like, I didn't forget, Joe. Like I didn't forget. It's like, I don't want to stiff the kid.
He Twittered it.
Well, how about this?
Make sure you catch me at Joe DeRosa's show.
How about this? He's here.
Yeah, I know.
How about he auditions?
All right.
He gives you his best 2 minutes. We'll make believe that, you know, it's the Stress Factory. And then he'll do his thing. And if you like it, then he could do it for you at the Stress Factory.
All right. That's
fair enough.
I'm
at least
we'll
let
that.
Him audition today. He's here. Patrice is going to be at Bananas Comedy Club in Poughkeepsie. So those two shows aren't really competing with each other because they're far enough apart. So see Patrice if
unless
you're north
some people
of the city.
From the Stress Factory want to just come on down.
Yeah.
Somebody got tickets. We'll redeem Stress Factory tickets.
Two for one if you got a Stress Factory ticket.
If you have a Stress Factory ticket for tonight, tomorrow.
We'll let not only you in, but five of your pals.
That's fucked up, man. That's some fucked up shit. You know, a motherfucker did some shit like that?
Why would you do that in his final days? That's not nice.
Man, I'm sorry,
It's the end of days, man.
Just don't die in studio, because I don't want your fucking ghost coming back.
Oh, I would love it, and just Anthony couldn't come in here anymore because he's too scared.
The studio's haunted.
The pessimistic, depressed ghost of Joe DeRosa is haunting the studio.
Full house, Patrice O'Neill and Joe DeRosa in studio. Now, Joe's playing the Stress Factory tonight and tomorrow.
Yeah.
And he got Bobo to do like a guest spot, but now you're having second thoughts, I guess, huh, Joe?
I want to have Bobo on. I just don't want it to, you know, I got to record an album, so I just don't want it to be a goddamn pit in the show.
You think it could go wrong? With retarded Bobo and his fucking uncontrollable little hog.
Possibly.
Still my favorite video I've done so far. Your fucking reaction to that video, dude, is
painful.
One for the ages, man.
Which
one
video?
It's too long to get into now.
It's just Bobo, ridiculous to have Bobo on.
We learned that Bobo gets hard very easily when you start talking about broads.
You just gotta talk about a girl.
And it gets rock hard, this little fucking thing he calls a penis. And then you start talking about the Mets and it instantly goes down.
It goes away, and then you talk about girls again and it goes back.
So we ridiculous. Told Patrice about it, and he saw it for the first time, and a guy's reaction on video, it's just ridiculous.
Yeah.
It's fucking ridiculous.
It's in the top seven laughs I've ever had.
It's
that was a good one.
It's an unbelievable thing, control he's got, just like that.
Telling you after the show on Tuesday, with the last time I was here, when Bobo took his dick out and he had the pre-cum dripping out of it.
Oh.
That was one of the hardest times I ever laughed in my fucking life.
Yeah,
dude.
His cock has given us a lot of humor, which is...
We've laughed at his dick many times.
I have it on my phone. All you see is Bobo and Danny and E-Rock almost vomiting when he tries to smell his pubes. And then when you...
I forgot about that.
I'm laughing right into the speaker because I'm right next to the phone. And then Anthony's evil laugh like... That starts coming in. And then you hear you punching the fucking console. So funny, man.
That's an amazing
episode. There's a lot going on there.
Why don't we get Bobo in? He could at least try out his material, see if it's worthy of you,
man. Shit.
You having on your show at the Stress Factory.
That's fucking genius.
Yeah.
He's opening up for your album that you're going to sell.
Hey, Bobo.
I didn't know I was recording when we plugged the date last night.
Bobo, your hair grows fast.
Yeah, that's right. It grows pretty quick.
What are you wearing? And talking to the mic. You've been on the show.
If you're a cartoon fan, you have to be a cartoon fan or a comics fan and know that Bobo looks like the Mole Man right now.
The Mole Man.
You have to be a fan of comics. He's the Mole Man right this second. Well, he's just missing his hat and his fucking thing that he has.
Well, for some reason, Sam thought this is Sam's idea to wear this here.
What is it?
I don't know. It's when it
looks like a Snuggie.
It's a Snuggie.
No, it's not a Snuggie.
What, Danny?
It's a Slanket.
A Slanket.
But
nice.
That's just a ripoff of a Snuggie.
No, it's not. It's a little
and
different.
And it's a WWE product.
WWE.
Yeah.
Does one of the wrestlers wear this, Danny?
No, it just
you're
gets cold in each arena.
Yeah, they don't have the heat
in
on.
The fucking Quicken Loans arena. It gets freezing. Yeah.
Well, we're not going to spend a lot of time with Bobo because, quite frankly, he drives the audience nuts. So, but we want to see if he's got material to warm up for Joe DeRosa at Stress Factory tonight.
Yeah, Bobo, here, I want to hear your material. I'm recording my CD tonight, and I didn't know that last time, so it's got to be a tight show, man.
Well,
so
if
we can't do it this time, we'll do it next time. But it's do some material. Let me hear some of your shit before I say, yeah, definitely come down and, you know.
All right, I'll tell you this one. I have to say, I hate these frickin' psychiatric drugs and their stupid side effects.
Wait a minute, you got to go, right, don't you, everybody?
Yeah, right?
Are you sick of it? Don't you guys hate psychiatric drugs?
Do you hate that? I hate those stupid side effects. I was on this one that I had to get taken off right after 2 days. This thing, I couldn't move frickin' anything. I'm like so, I couldn't move anything so much, I think... Geez, somebody get me a forklift. I couldn't move anything. They thought, what is this? Is this a guy doing a human statue bit on the subway?
Joe, this is perfect for you.
Waiter! Give me two more of these!
Continue, Bobo. Continue.
Old time, I look like this, and I'm walking around sounding like Tom Menino going... Get the bus change. I'm trying to say that to my sister, and then no one's just freaking standing, and then I'm calling, and my mother thinking there's nothing wrong with me. They said, Bob, there is something wrong. This medicine is freaking having a horrible side effect, and you damn know well. There's no way I can fix I couldn't move anything. As a matter of fact, it took me like a whole hour to pee.
Oh, shit, he's killing.
Joe, this is perfect for you.
Oh, you got to leave this in the fucking CD, Joe.
Yeah, yeah. This is perfect for you, Joe. What do you think, Joe?
I don't know what the fuck he's talking about, but you guys...
It's a psychiatric drug side effect.
What's the mystery?
It's killing with you guys, so, can I hear a little bit more? Do we have time to hear?
A little more.
Do you have another subject, Bobo? Maybe another subject aside from psychiatric drugs?
Well, I got the other thing. This annoying $1 guy... $1, $1, $1, $1, $1, $1, $1, $1, $1. I said, yes. Let me ask you a question. How much do these batteries that will just go dead in an hour cost?
Dollar store batteries.
I love saying that every time I see that guy selling the batteries on the subway. I say that every time.
What?
Yeah.
How much do those batteries that last only an hour cost?
And he says $1, $1, $1.
Yeah, exactly. That's all he says.
Joe, you gotta have them.
I don't know.
Because not only does he say material at the Stress Factory, this is famous material now because it's been broadcasted.
This is gold, Jerry.
This is gold.
Joe, this is killing.
It will be great if it's wall-to-wall O&A fans in there. If it's just New Brunswick folk. You know,
it's gonna kill a New Brunswick folk too.
Yeah, man. You got anything else? Another subject?
Well, wait, how many minutes do you have? Like, how many minutes?
We usually get like 3 minutes, to 5 minutes.
That's like a 5 minute thing. So I wrote stuff based on that.
You wrote another joke. Let's hear the last joke.
I wrote stuff based on the 5 minutes.
How are you
gonna
get out to New Brunswick tonight?
I just take the train, a few trains.
Few trains?
Oh, Jesus.
Just three trains.
Just three trains.
What time is the show?
it's around 8 o'clock, but I take...
Pioneers didn't take three trains when they went out to California.
He's
going to show up. We all didn't make it.
I live in Maspeth. So I have to take a bus to get to the nearest train station.
Uh-huh.
It's one of the few areas in New York City that's not near a train station.
What time are you going to leave?
I'm probably going to have to leave around 5 or so. I'll probably arrive around 6.
You're like when fucking Liza Minnelli went out to Arthur's house for the party.
I gotta walk up. And this is actually true. I gotta walk up to the Q18 bus, take that to the 61st Street Woodside.
Oh shit!
Which is by the way a block from where I grew up. By the way,
Bobo, why are you explaining your fucking route? No one gives a shit.
I
want to
hear it. But then what? Then what do you do?
I'm fucking enamored, right? I'm into this story about his buses.
Then what do you do?
Not because I'm trying to show you an example of
how are you going to get to the fucking show? The show's at 8:00.
Patrice, meet him at the station, drive him
and
out.
And now the station doesn't
I got a show, nigga.
Station doesn't drop you off right at the comedy club. What do you do after you take all those trains?
Well, I just walk there. It's a short walk.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, it's a short walk.
But what train, how are you, explain from the time you leave your door to the time you get to the comedy club, what's your journey?
Well, I leave the door, head out to a bus, then transfer to the 7, then I got a train. And then I transfer to the 1 to Penn Station.
Yeah.
Then I got to take the New Jersey Transit train up to New Brunswick.
Joe, will you just pick him up? If he's going to do time for your show.
And that's like a block. And that's
Bobo.
Like a,
Joe will pick you up tonight.
This is
pick
like, up a, it's like a casino and Pesci has to keep switching cars just to drive out to his own jewelry store. How are you getting into Stress Factory, Joe?
I'm not taking the R7 to the 1 to the West Side Highway or whatever. Yeah, train. I'm going to take a nice train.
So why don't you fucking just meet him?
Yeah, meet Bobo, man. If you guys are working together, you might as well travel together.
You know, I can't.
Why is that, Joe?
Okay, what train? What time is your train that gets you to Stress Factory?
3:00.
Yeah, you're about an hour and a half right before me.
Yeah.
You two should go together.
Why don't you go together?
I gotta get out there. I gotta do afternoon radio.
You guys gotta work on the show. Make sure it runs smoothly. Bobo, Joe.
So you're gonna have you're gonna have this guy host, then bring up Bobo, then bring up the feature, then you come and do your CD.
What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have the guy host, then the feature, then me, then the show's gonna end.
But Bobo. But where was you gonna put Bobo at though?
I think I'm going to do Bobo next time. I don't think this time is the time.
No, Joe. He brought his tickets and stuff, man. Yeah, Joe, you can't.
Wait,
you can't
Joe, talk to Bobo. You don't want him performing tonight?
You can't fucking do that. You can't fucking fire Bobo tonight, man.
We got to have a tight show. I got
to
record
my
album.
Have a tight. You don't have to have
he's
a tight fucking show.
You heard his material. What do you mean?
You don't have to have a tight show.
The problem is I do a lot of material about dollar store batteries.
So what, though? Different context.
I don't want us to step on each other.
Don't fucking fire Bobo tonight.
I'm not fired, next time we'll do it.
I won't use the dollar store battery bit.
Yeah, there you go.
What's your replacement bit?
I see what you're doing. You can't fire fucking Bobo, man. Let him work tonight.
Yeah, Bobo, you want to work tonight,
he bought
right?
his fucking tickets, man. Come on, man.
He wants to work tonight, Joe.
I know he does. Why I need to take him off the show.
Jesus.
No, we got to keep it tight, I'm saying.
Well, why keep it tight? Shorten up the fucking MC, shorten up the feature, let Bobo come in after the MC, and then the feature comes on and gets the crowd, like, fucking calms them down from after Bobo.
Yeah.
And then brings you on, man. Mm-hmm. Bring Bobo.
I like it.
Hey, Joe, if you don't want Bobo, then you tell him to his face. Stop beating around the bush and saying next time.
Bobo.
This is terrible.
I don't want you tonight.
This is fucking terrible.
I want to have you on next time.
No, what's the difference between next time?
That's a lie.
No, that's not. I swear to God. I didn't know I was recording my CD this time when I asked him last time.
That's bullshit. Look at his fucking face. I don't even want to look at him now.
Tell him the truth.
Fucking kid, man.
Bobo, are you sad if we don't do it tonight, man?
Now I have no problem with that. I'll be there Saturday then.
No. I'm saying I got to record tonight and Saturday. So let's do it next date that I do there. Is that all right?
All right, no problem. I'll still be in the audience.
Are you upset? Yeah, come. You can still come to the show.
Why the fuck would he come after you fired him?
Yeah. Now I'm still gonna be the audience anyway.
How far are you from Poughkeepsie?
How far am I from...
No, I know what you're trying to do.
I ain't putting Bobo on my fucking show. I didn't promise him nothing.
Yeah, you promised him,
Joe. You promised him, and now you're firing him.
No, I'm not firing him. I'm just saying
Bobo,
I didn't know
you're
I was
being
recording.
Fired.
No. Bobo, I'll do it next time, I promise.
I live out in Queens.
Yeah, this is terrible, man. Oh, this is terrible.
Bobo. These are making me feel bad a little bit.
Yeah, it's fucking terrible, dude. Put
Bobo,
him on.
He don't watch you.
What do you got besides the dollar bill thing? Give us one more bit.
Now the other one I don't remember very well. I have that one written down.
Well, just kind of wing it.
Yeah, wing it.
Basic idea.
Let me see. I'm trying to remember.
You just sounded so judgmental and gay. You went, give us one more bit.
Give us one more. Just see if he could do it, Joe. Just see.
I'm literally fucking in pain for Bobo right now fired. Right, he gets up in the morning. He was gonna go home. Not probably not even sleep practicing his fucking act for you, and you fucking fire him the day of the show in the morning.
Hey, he's excited, Joe.
Fucking awful, man.
Nothing wrong with that.
And he's gonna be there still to support you. Unbelievable.
Bobo, come out. I'll tell you what, man. Come out to the shows. If I can get you on, if I figure it'll work out,
you're the boss,
I'll do it.
Joe. Oh, you're the fucking boss.
I know.
You tell Vinny and it's done.
Come out to the shows. If I can get you on, I
what
will.
What the? Joe.
I'm not gonna
Joe.
I can't promise.
Huh? You can get him on. You saying come out there, and if you're feeling fucking omnipotent and benevolent, you'll put him on. You fucking asshole.
The end. Joe's an asshole.
Fucking dick.
Damn.
You know. I'm sorry. All right, let's do
it. Oh, wait a minute. I got another one.
One more
bit. Okay, he's got another one.
I got another one.
Go ahead.
What do you mean you got another one?
I got another one about the bus announcements.
Okay.
I noticed that I'm on the bus recently. They've got these digital announcements.
Yeah.
And do they really need the digital announcements? They got a guy in driving the bus who you can hear pretty clear. He's out in the open. He's not in some kind of booth or something. You can hear the guy.
Yeah,
you need a useless digital announcement. And these new ones freaking annoy me. Please exit through the back door. And then you press the button and it says, the door is now closing. Gee, I already know that. I don't.
Right? What makes him not deserve to go on?
I don't need an announcement.
He fucking deserves.
What the fuck, Joe?
He fucking deserves.
He just proved himself.
He deserves some of your fucking time after that.
That's right, man.
Are you fucking serious, Joe?
Oh, Jesus.
That fucking bus stuff, that material?
I killed.
It's good stuff.
Wait a minute. The fucking hour long dead dollar battery bit didn't move you enough to put him on stage? Promised the guy, man.
Mr. Bobo, we've got your tape. We listened to it. Jerry's very interested. And we'll be getting back to you.
And then he didn't even offer Bobo like a fucking at least a VIP apology.
I said I'll take care of him tonight if he comes out to the show. If I can get him on, I will. I'll comp his tickets
Stop
and all that
saying
shit.
If you can get him
shallow
on.
Shallow promises.
That's what he wants.
This is what I'm saying.
Joe DeRosa, king of the shallow promise.
You see how he makes big, like, I'm sure promises, but then there's one that he goes, I'll see if I can do it.
Yeah,
he's
I'll
like,
see.
Hey, I'll comp you a steak, a fucking VIP. Yeah, yeah.
Whoa, no, I didn't say steak.
And then,
because he'd rather have charity than fucking be on stage.
Right. Yeah, going after his dream. You can help his fucking dream.
Joe, very disappointing.
You're a dream snatcher.
I'm disappointed in all of us this morning.
Who let you get up on stage?
Tell him.
What comic let you get up on stage?
Tell him.
That was Voss.
Rich Voss.
Rich Voss, the great Rich
He's
Voss.
He's confident enough.
He has
in
a
his
heart.
Material.
Joe doesn't.
Rich Voss is confident enough in his act that he was able to have Bobo open up for him without saying, how am I going to follow that? You know?
Yeah, I know. It's tough.
And Vinny's bringing on Bobo.
Vinny supports Bobo. Let's hear this. We should listen a little of the actual.
So you know him as a regular performer on the Opie and Anthony radio show, all the way from Queens.
This is what you're going to miss, Joe.
A loud, warm, Stress Factory welcome to my good friend Bobo. Let him hear it.
Listen to that. Bobo hits the stage, high-fiving people like a retard.
This guy got it. Bobo got it.
You did, New Jersey.
Hear that.
But first of all, how many here screwed over a stockholder to come here tonight? I know, I watch CNN. I know what's been going on. Well, first, I'd like to introduce to you. You know him from the Opie and Anthony show.
Did he say first?
Yeah.
Could you read
that? That is great.
You missed his name. Jersey's own Rich Voss.
Here's what I love about Bobo. He understood that he bombed.
And he
had the chops.
That's right.
To fucking move it along, man.
Let's go.
What happened was I didn't know. I didn't know how much time they gave me. So that time I made it a little bit shorter.
And he respects the light.
This guy's a professional.
I think I added a little bit more to that the second time when I did the second show that night.
Oh, did you?
All right, I'll tell you what.
Because you guys are missing
some good stuff here.
How many over a stockholder to come here tonight.
Uh-huh. Well, it's a different
audience. CNN. I know what's been going on. Well, first, I'd like to introduce you. You know him from the Opie and Anthony show. He's the Jew with the right amount of stupidity and the horse of a smile. Give it up for New Jersey's own Rich Voss.
The horse of a smile?
No, I meant I screwed up the line. I said the smile of a horse.
Yeah, but you said the horse of a smile.
See, Rich did it.
As a regular, you know it.
And this is for the late show.
Now he's going to rip.
Put your hands together for the one and only Bobo, everybody.
He goes longer for the late show.
Look at the people. Love him.
Oh, he changed his clothes.
New Jersey! All right, who's here from Queens? Who do we got here from Queens? Oh, we got my relatives here. We got my cousin, Mikey. He's from Queen, who grew up in the same neighborhood as me. He's now in Smith Temple, Violet. He managed to make it out here from the city LAE traffic, along with, let's see, we got here my Aunt Sarah and my uncle Willie from Flushing. They made it out here from the city traffic on the LAE. Believe me, it's shitty. Those of you who don't go to Long Island Expressway, it's very shitty. The traffic, I mean.
Bob was very distinguished.
Who screwed over a stockholder? Oh, we got one that screwed over a stockholder. I think you're probably going to end up having to get that anal rape by Bernie Madoff. Who here is from Jersey? He's got an interesting job.
You can't use that tonight. You can't fucking use his energy. Nah. You're an asshole, Joe. Jesus, this makes me forget how to do comedy. Like I'm getting nervous about my show tonight. Like, I'm like, fuck me. Oh, all right, Bobo.
Give it up for the guy who has the right amount of stupidity and has a horse-like smile.
See, he writes material, Joe. He doesn't just go up there and wing it.
He writes
material.
It's like when you get hired to do a corporate. He writes for the people in the room.
Do you want
me
to go to the phones and see what the listeners think?
Oh, wow. I'll be shocked to hear their opinion on this.
What are you talking about, Joe? Relax. We don't set up phone calls here on this show. Let's go to Jeff in Rochester. Jeff.
Yeah, good morning, boys.
Hey.
Bobo, fuck Joe. I got 8 tickets. You can have them all and bring 7 of your finest friends with you tonight.
All right. Thank you. Let's go to Jeremy in Jersey. Jeremy?
Good evening.
Hey, Jeremy.
Hey, Joe, man. We got like 7 tickets between me and the guys I work with. If you don't put Bobo on, man, we're not fucking coming.
Oh, shit.
Let's say hi to Rob in Jersey. Rob.
Yeah, Joe, if you don't let him go on, I got 12 people going, you're going to have 8 tickets.
Oh, man. People are dumping their tickets.
Steve in Jersey, Steve.
Joe, don't be a selfish dude. Did you hear that bus bit? I pissed my pants.
Hey, guys, pissing his pants.
All right, let's go to Bill in Jersey. A lot of Jersey calls coming in.
Hello, Bill.
Hey, Joe, I just want to tell you that I got 4 tickets, and I'm going to bring colors if you don't let them on.
Let's go to Kevin in Rhode Island.
Oh,
Kevin.
Shit.
Hey, guys. Hey, Joe, man, I got 2 tickets. My wife and I were going to head out over there tonight, but I'll tell you what, you can have them. Thanks.
You're going to have a what?
You basically need at this point to put Bobo on that stage.
How did they all know to do the same thing?
What are you talking about?
Like, how did they all know to call up and go, I got this many tickets, we're going to bail, I got
serious.
This many tickets?
Because they're serious.
They ain't
you can't set
around.
That shit up.
They ain't fucking around.
We ain't setting nothing up. That's just people talking,
all right,
Joe.
Bobo, come out tonight
And I'll do the thing you did for Voss. Introduce me. Bring me on for one of the shows.
Yeah, but he has to do his material.
He's got to do like a couple
of shows.
You
saw it. It's like 2 minutes.
Well, I'm just going to do one of the things. I'm going to do the psychiatric drug bit.
Yeah, that's a good one. That's good.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah, that's like
that one, the psychiatric drug bit.
You got to admit, that's like Woody Allen's moose bit. It's his brilliant benchmark. That's his benchmark bit. That's like the seven dirty words, Joe.
That's the fucking...
that's his go-to bit.
That's Kevin Meaney's We Are the World.
Joe, agree? You're kind of in a bad spot here, Joe. I'm telling you.
I seriously...
Our listeners are as vicious.
They can Bob Nelson's juggling handkerchief bit.
Bob Nelson's Jiffy Jeff.
hold on.
Fucking football player.
Let's go to Hydro, because Joe's still not sure. Hydro?
Yeah, this is Hydro from North Carolina. I got 7 tickets, and Bobo better be on stage, or I ain't coming, nigga.
Let's go to Brooklyn A's. Brooklyn A's.
Oh, my brother's a bachelor party tonight. We were going to your show with 25 of his friends. No Bobo, no go. Just this in is... City Bar earlier.
Joe, let's...
It's like that I Love Lucy episode. Ricky Ricardo will not be performing tonight? I canceled the tickets.
Oh, my God.
Joe, you're in the middle of a hostage negotiation right now. Let's be honest with each other. So let's work this out.
Oh, you guys...
You got a major problem on your hands.
You guys railroaded me.
Oh, I'm going to be representing Bobo. Bobo will introduce you.
People are going to be like, we want Bobo.
You want the early show or the late show?
Bobo.
We got to negotiate here. We'll allow... You to pick which show, early or late?
Early, because I don't need any fuel added to the fire on the late show.
You're recording all 4 shows. Don't worry about it. You'll get enough material. So he'll intro you.
Thank you.
Early show tonight at the Stress Factory.
Yeah, intro.
And you're recording your fucking CD.
Yeah, you can do.
And what joke? Let's negotiate the joke. 2 jokes. He's got 4, so you got to let him do 2.
Let him do half.
Okay, do
that.
2 jokes.
Which one do you want? The dollar one's a good strong bit too.
The 2 jokes of your choosing.
Which ones you want, Bobo?
No, I'm saying I want to give him carte blanche. You can do whatever 2 jokes he wants.
Which one do you want?
Well, I'm gonna do the one about the psychiatric drug.
Yeah, that's a brilliant one.
And then the other one, since I know you were doing a thing about the dollar battery guy. I'm gonna do the thing about the new bus announcements.
Yeah, the bus announcement is pretty strong too.
What do you think you'll close with? Because you want to close with the strongest one. What do you think is strongest?
Welcome to the show, Joe.
Welcome. I've been coming in for 6 months.
I know, but this is when it becomes official. We've been hazed.
I'll close with the psychiatric drug bit.
I forgot. Why contribute to the radio show? My name's only on the fucking billboard, Bobo.
Can we call Vinny Brand and see if he's cool with it?
If you know anything about fraternities, we've been hazing you for a long time. This is your hell night. You get past this, you're fucking in. You're one of the guys.
I think of it more like a prospect biker gang guy finally getting his patch for the back of his jacket.
Right.
I think of it more like I'm already like raped and almost dead, like in Casualties of War, and you want to go for one last fucking ass pump. That's how I see it.
All right, so we're on the same. So we're basically on the same page, Joe.
Bobo, seriously, come out. You introduce me. I don't give a shit. Go ahead, do it. You know.
Just make sure there's a big buffer between Bobo and you.
No, it'll be fun. Look, for the ONA guys that are out there, they'll get a kick out of it.
You saw him kill on that fucking Voss tape.
Yeah.
Come on.
For all the people that called up pretending like they were coming to the show just to get in my head, they'll get a kick out of it. Good for them.
I'm sick of Joe. I don't like how you're treating Bobo, man. This motherfucker's working hard, dude.
Yeah,
I'm saying he can come out and introduce me. What else do you want from
me? Writing shit and everything. He's actually taking this seriously. If some guy was just fucking around going, yeah, I'll come up there, I'll just fight. Yeah.
All right, good.
And you could do that. Whatever 2 jokes you want, I don't care. I would never tell an opener, somebody opening for me, what jokes they can do. That's not cool. I would never
Bobo, you know what? You're like an artist, man. When you're up there, then you'll decide. That's what you should do. Yeah.
Or maybe riff a little.
Yeah. Do some crowd work, too. Joe
just
loves
rip.
That. Yeah, Joe loves when you do crowd
work.
Let's do some crowd. Work on your crowd work now,
work
Bobo.
The crowd.
Yeah. Work the crowd.
Listen to me introducing the crowd. Right?
No. You want Sam and you got to work the actual crowd.
Yeah, you got to work the crowd work. What do you do for a living? And then you do something funny on the guy's job or something like that. It's, you know, thinking on your feet right off the cuff.
Yeah, let's see your crowd work there, Bobo.
All right, so I'll say, all right, good evening. Right, first I'll like intro, I'll say like good evening, right? And I'll say what do you guys what do one of you guys do for a living?
I'm a comic.
No, give him something that really might happen.
You just fucking threw him so bad.
Say a real job.
Say a real job there, Patrice. Pretend that's true.
I do construction, man. Actually, Bubba, you should really look at a person and ask them what they do, not who does something.
Yeah.
Look at Patrice and say, "What do you do for a living?"
All right, so you, sir, you're the guy wearing the gold chain. What is it?
I do construction.
Oh, you do construction. So what is it? Has anything ever felt? Anything's fallen on you while you're eating fast food during lunch break?
Oh, shit. This is going well. All right, move on to Joe DeRosa. Make sure Joe's a customer.
That was actually better than anything I could think of.
That was actually one of the best fucking insult lines I've ever heard.
All right,
has anything dropped on me while I was eating fast food at my fucking... At my imaginary construction job. Right,
yeah. I like this.
You son of a bitch, you.
All right, move on to Joe DeRosa. Make believe he's in the audience.
Wait, so what about you, sir?
How you doing, man?
So what do you do for a living?
I'm an accountant.
Oh, you're an accountant. So when any mistakes you made, you...
Come on, Bobo!
Any mistakes that do people just go when you're an accountant, they just call other Christ killer in the background?
Jesus Christ. Oh, you went right for the juju.
No, he didn't go right for it.
he took a minute. Bobo, do that again, please. I want to get you, Bobo, doing crowd work to me directly.
So you're an accountant.
Ask me again.
How many people have uttered Christ killer during the times they've asked for your services?
Ask him what he does for a living. Start all over again.
So you, sir, what is it you do for a living?
I'm a chef.
Oh, you're a chef. Ever accidentally caught your ever burnt your hand?
Yeah, I did once.
Yeah, I could imagine you probably walked in. They all got scared walking there with your hand. That injured hand.
Who got scared?
No, and everybody that's walked in saw that burn.
In the kitchen? Like the workers in the kitchen?
No, I'm talking about out in the street.
What are you talking about?
No, I was talking about the burn on your hand.
That people got scared in the street with it?
Yeah, that you go to a guy and you probably went somewhere and you had to hand the guy the cash and they saw that burnt on your head. They got so scared.
How would they react? How would you react if you saw a burnt hand?
Well, I'd ask, like, what? How'd you get that?
I'm just trying. I'm throwing shit back. You got to be ready. Sometimes the crowd talks back to you.
Yeah, they talk back. That's you got to shut them down, Bobo.
Will you do Anthony?
Anthony,
you got to get a good one. You, sir, you in the 5'11" gear. What is it you do in it? What is it you do for a living?
I'm an auto mechanic.
Or you're an auto mechanic. How close have you come to a car dropping on your foot?
Never. We have a lot of safety in place that wouldn't happen, sir.
How long do you stall and repair job for people that are getting their car fixed by you?
How long have I stole a...
No, stalled on a job.
Oh, stalled on a job? We're very reputable. Very reputable.
This fucking audience doesn't know what it's in for. This guy is stingingly quick.
Joe, this is going to be great. Definite crowd work, too.
Come on. You never...
This is Bobo Rickles, nigga. Don't play games with him.
You never left anything in a car that just someone that you just know, your car, like someone that just really bothered you? You noticed it was their car and left anything?
This is not an interview, Bobo. You're fucking making up funny shit, not...
Yeah, all right, well... His crowd work is pretty good. He's going to do crowd work. All right,
something that... One more thing that's a little different. Say, hey, anybody here married?
Anybody here married?
Yeah,
I'm married.
Are you, sir? I hope you have the check. I hope you have a checkbook ready.
Oh, shit. Your gold digging ass wife.
Damn. Damn. Yes, I've been married 32 happy years.
At 32 years in this country, you're gonna have to have a checkbook ready at some point, and a lawyer and a check ready for a law and a lawyer on the speed dial.
Oh God!
Come on, Joe.
I'm married, amazing. With kids. I have kids.
Oh, and you might need two lawyers.
Oh shit! All right.
This motherfucker's Tommy gun fast, baby.
And in the audience, Bobo, this guy used to be married, but he's divorced now.
Oh yeah.
Oh, what happened? You're losing more money than Obama's tax plan.
Topical political jokes too. Wow, he's on fire.
This is not just a guy with a moving dick. This guy's
got some shit.
Fast.
I like it. All right.
Put him right on the fucking CD, Joe. What are you waiting for?
He's gonna.
He's prodigy-like with his quickness.
Hole any deeper, please.
It could be one of those like hidden traps.
You got to be cool committing to having him on the CD.
Everyone thinks your CD's over. Next thing you know, that fucking all of a sudden Bobo pops
and
out.
And Bobo, what's your comedy name? Your stage name?
Well, I use mostly the name Daniel Bobo Curlin.
Curlin?
That's my real name, Daniel Curlin.
Daniel.
How
Bobo
you spell your
Curlin.
Last name?
K-U-R-L-A-N.
Curlin.
Bobo.
Curlin.
They're calling
Why do people like Bobo have the exact names that they should have? Like, it's just his name is Daniel Curlin. And it just looks like a fucking idiotic Curlin.
And they've actually spelled that my name wrong numerous times over the years.
Why?
I don't know why. For some reason, it's just one of those names that people can spell.
How the fuck would you spell it?
Well, they've at my high school.
What do they do? Is either the only way you can make that mistake is with a C instead of a K, right?
Well, I've seen most of the time I see the C, or my personal favorite, when I graduated elementary school, they added an O to my name.
Curlin.
No, it was like, I think I read it like Curlin O.
Curlando?
Maybe they mixed the Bobo up. Maybe you should go by Bolando.
Back then, my sister wasn't even born.
Tony Bolando.
My sister wasn't born yet back then.
You sure that was a letter? Oh, not your grade point, Harrison?
No,
he answers it like it's a real question. Jesus
He graduated
Christ.
With an O. Average.
And Bobo, they're calling you Bobo Hicks on instant feedback.
Yeah.
And you know what? Joe's a big fan of Bill Hicks.
Bobo Hicks.
Bobo Hicks. Fucking topical.
Bobo Bruce.
I'll tell you what they did in my high school yearbook. They spelled my name K-U-R-L-I-N.
Oh, shit.
They misspelled my high school yearbook.
You haven't gotten
over that
my
last
one, I'm
name.
Sure.
He remembered some fucking shitty thing they did to his name when he was in elementary school.
I couldn't even name one of my high school teachers at this point. Hey, Danny put up a thing up there. I don't know if this is going to work, but we have someone else that should be warming up for you tonight, Joe. And I'm not sure if he's willing to come out of retirement or not. Uh-oh. Is the virus willing to come out of retirement today?
Oh, I hope so.
Have you ever heard the virus?
No.
The virus is really funny.
I don't know if he's willing to do this.
Who's the virus?
The virus broke his hand over this bit, so I'm not really sure if he wants to come out of retirement.
The virus doesn't really like being the virus.
This guy still rings in my head.
Oh, shit.
Oh, man. This guy, now he's bad-mouthing other comics.
We're all looking down the long hallway, hoping that the virus would do the right thing and come out of retirement. Sam's trying to pep him up, but I don't know if this is going to happen today. The virus is terrific.
Does he work here or something?
Yeah, the virus.
Tell the fucking virus to get his fat ass down here.
the catchphrase for the virus is we're looking for one punchline. Just one.
Where's he going?
We're looking for one punchline.
That's it.
We're one all looking down the hall. I don't know.
Where is he supposed
Sam.
To be going?
Sam has his arms up in the
Where's
air.
Where's Larry David pissed. Walking down the hallway, too?
Oh, shit. They're chanting Sam. Virus on instant feedback. Virus. Yes. Virus.
Well, let's hear it, man.
Well, I don't know. Sam's not the virus. So Sam's coming in to give us the bad news.
What's going on with
Sam,
him?
What's up with the virus today?
I think he's trying to big shot you guys. He says he doesn't want to perform. I don't know why he wouldn't want to perform, though.
I think the virus is having trouble getting up.
The virus needs a forklift.
Oh! Holy shit.
I hope E-Rock knows that was only a joke I was making about him.
No, you weren't.
Oh, the virus is E-Rock?
No,
oh,
the virus is the virus.
Oh, God damn it. Did I just... Bobo blew it first. Yeah. Sorry.
No, the virus is the virus. Hey, Bobo.
Come on, Bobo.
Bobo, there's a guy in a wheelchair in the front row. Crowd work.
Yeah.
How do you handle that situation? Because you still got to be a comic, but you don't want to like get too crazy, right?
Fine line.
Make believe Joe's in a wheelchair.
Yeah.
You're on a wheelchair, man.
I feel sorry for you. I feel sorry for the guy that has to give you sponge baths every day.
Why would you say that? That's very hurtful.
No, because I know he's probably home. He might be homophobic.
You're a faggot in a wheelchair.
I didn't say you're a faggot. I said
you're a wheelchair faggot.
I was trying to hang out a crippled character.
I didn't say that the guy in the wheelchair was a faggot. I meant how some people might be get. I'm sure a lot of people that have to give another guy a sponge bath for a living. Probably.
It's hilarious that he went there.
Why don't you talk about his colostomy bag, too, fucking Bobo?
Feel homophobic having to give another guy a sponge bath.
He went right to the fact that you can't wash yourself.
Believe me, I remember my uncle never got over that sight the first time he had... My uncle used to be one of those home health aides.
Yeah.
And he says that was the annoying part of the job was having to do that. Having to give another guy a sponge bath.
You know what I just figured out with Bobo? I always thought that he didn't have the thoughts, but I realized it's the opposite. It's like the beautiful mind. He can't get to the thoughts fast enough.
This fucker is flying through his goddamn head.
Semi-genius. I have a new respect for Bobo. Yeah. It's just that there's a retarded thing that's fighting. There's a war in his mind. There's something retarded and something genius fighting. And the retarded thing is trying to keep the genius from getting out.
Yeah.
He's as quick as a fucking sound mind.
So you're going to be very happy by this tonight.
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
You just need
Bobo
like...
will be on that stage tonight at the Stress Factory when Joe DeRosa records the CD. Are we going to try to get the virus? Are they trying to get him again? What's up, Danny? No? It ain't happening today?
Bobo needs like the virus doesn't like performing thing of electroshock therapy, I bet, to kill the retarded part. And then he'd be a genius.
He's a fucking... He's like Sigmund Freud.
He's smiling. He knows it. Bobo, you know you're a genius, right?
Yeah, I know that. Believe me, there's a reason why I aced probably everything except for the math regions the first time.
You want to see how much of a genius he is? Sam, we're going to show everyone how much of a genius is. It's time for Bobo Spelling Bee.
Yes.
Bobo Spelling Bee. We're going to show his genius.
Here it comes. Here it comes.
Bobo Spelling Bee.
Well, this one, I'm not so good at. I depend on spell check.
Well, no, you do all right, though.
Sam, if you can spell Curland.
Yeah.
Of course I can spell my own last name. You can spell Daniel Curland.
Patrice, do we have an update on the virus?
The virus, he won't even sit in his chair because I tried pulling his chair to the studio. And now he's standing up in the office. He's got Bobo jokes. He's insulting Bobo in the office.
Really?
So why doesn't he come in and just insult Bobo as the virus? That could be good.
That's what I told him. And Rob Cross, his boss, is down there telling him.
That's brilliant. Yeah. The virus comes in to insult Bobo as the virus. Let's get that done. In the meantime, Patrice, give Bobo a word to spell. This is just amazing. Don't get too crazy with the words. Something that we all know.
Laboratory.
Oh, that's an easy one. That's a Jesus, Patrice, perfect. Perfect level of spelling right there.
Yes, that's a good one.
Did you say laboratory or lavatory?
Laboratory.
Like bathroom?
Yeah.
Okay.
Uh-huh. You got it, Bobo?
Jesus.
Oh, yeah, you got it.
Yeah, he's got it, man.
No, lavatory like bathroom. Is that it? Okay.
All right.
The fuck is
all right,
that
Sam's scribble? Got it. Sam, why don't you
Sam?
Tell us what he spelled.
How do you spell lavatory?
After repeating lavatory several times, he spelled it L-A-B-R-A-T-O-R-Y.
Fuck!
That's laboratory or laboratory.
Jesus, laboratory. Bobo, I thought you said you didn't know how to spell.
All some right. things I do, some
yeah,
things
yeah,
I
that
don't.
One is perfect.
All right, I got a word for you.
Mm-hmm.
Executive.
Oh, okay, fuck. Okay. Executive, yes. We deal with them every day.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All right.
And he's left-handed, too, which makes him...
Yeah, southpaw.
Yeah.
Quick.
What do you mean he's left-handed?
Yeah, hurry.
Oh.
Come on.
Okay.
All right.
What? Am I retarded? I'm retarded.
I think you might have switched hands.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I swear to God. I thought he was...
Right-handed.
All right.
Executive. I've always been.
All right. We don't need an answer.
Okay, here we go. Executive.
All right. Executive.
Okay, executive.
Okay.
E-X... C E X C T I V.
There you go.
Oh wow! Executive.
Sam's laughing because he can't believe you got that one.
Yeah, this is blowing up in all our faces.
That's a tough one.
Hey, Marcel from Rhode Island. There's a woman with a cancer wig in the front row, Bobo. Going back to that improv, working the crowd. How do you deal with that? Woman with a cancer wig in the front row.
Hey, you, sir. That looks like a wig.
We said woman. You fuck.
But that's the joke.
Hey, yeah, because she's you, ugly sir. As all fuck.
All right,
yeah, he
right,
knew what he was
I'm,
doing. I'll be
right,
Jesus.
I'm stupid. I'm sorry. Because they want to be, like, you know, they're part of the crowd.
He started with an insult. I liked it. Hey, buddy.
Hey, pal.
Man, I feel sorry for you. How many people get blinded when you fall, when you, if you ever slip?
Yeah.
Slip. No, that's just amazing.
This is next level.
That means the wig flies off, because you know those cancer wigs are hard. That's the thing. See, he has all this the shit we should know. Yeah. Cancer wigs are very dangerous if they fly off.
This is next level comedy. This is poetry and
really
metaphor.
See, Joe,
I think that whole thing was about
you,
the blinded when they see the bald head.
Bobo's
maybe get all shot.
See, he takes it to another level.
Two levels above just two the levels. Idea of the wig, the dangerous wig.
Yeah.
Fuck me.
Bobo's jokes sound like Dylan lyrics.
why don't we get another word for Bobo? Joe, you got a word for Bobo to spell?
Yep. Factory.
Factory. That's
factory.
That might be too easy for
as
Bobo.
As in the stress factory.
Yes.
All right.
Very good.
Very smart.
So you might know how to...
Yeah, I mean,
what, is your head getting too
that
skinny
one was
for
that? Too easy. That one was too easy, Joe.
That was too easy,
slipped
Joe.
Off.
Oh.
There you go.
Way to wreck our spelling bit, Joe.
How about Roosevelt? Right.
Oh.
No.
Beautiful.
Beautiful.
Ah, beautiful, right.
This one you might get lucky. Oh, man, I might get this one wrong.
Oh, no. We know you could squeak these out. Hurry, faster.
Are you Daniel Curlin of the Queen's Curlin?
All right, here we go. Beautiful.
All right, beautiful.
Sam.
And in record time, too. B-U-T-I-F-E.
Absolutely.
Fucking A, buddy.
Who needs those pesky two other vowels?
I rushed through that one.
That's how it should be spelled.
You don't need that spell check anymore. Listen, Bobo, there's a Muslim in the front row. How do you deal with that?
Oh, Muslim.
But throw it at Patrice. Patrice is the Muslim.
They
so go.
Patrice.
Hey, you, sir. And I feel sorry for you. You probably get stuck 2 hours... 2 hours extra at the metal detector.
No! Oh, shit. Is it because I'm Muslim or fat?
Or black.
It's so many levels to that.
He hit you a three.
That
was a threefold.
Yeah. Hit him again.
Two hours at the metal detector. I could imagine you probably have to carry your own rape kit with you in your luggage.
What the fuck? Whoa!
getting big laughs, though.
Muzzles known as rapists?
No. I was talking about the security guard at the metal detector. No! Believe me, I'm sure there's some security guards out there that probably take advantage of their job.
I want to ask you a question. What's in a rape kit?
I have no idea what the heck is in a rape kit besides stuff that I guess used to recover
to rape, lady. It's stuff that rapes.
You use the rape kit to rape.
I think it's to recover
lady.
I think it's to recover DNA from, Bobo. You know, proof.
Bobo, I want to see how good you are. Ready for this one? Now listen closely.
Yeah.
Bobo's great.
Bobo is in the front row.
Oh, wow.
Oh, shit.
Oh, wait.
This is a challenge.
Malfunction.
Right,
danger. Listen.
Bobo is in the front row.
His ears are going to start smoking like when Kirk pulls that right. Double shit on the robots.
Make believe Danny is Bobo.
But
Bobo's in the front
row. If I am
here
and you are not, then I could not possibly be. Overload.
Bobo's in the front row.
Oh, my God. Look at it. He just broke. He stopped.
Yeah.
He stopped functioning.
And I feel sorry for you. You probably have to deal with the... getting raped by your brother jokes every time you walk down Grand Avenue.
No, I'm not lying. Yeah, that's right.
what are you gonna do?
Bubba, you was raped by your brother?
No, they think I was because I missed.
He doesn't like talking about Patrice. Don't bring it up.
They think I missed.
Don't bring it up.
They misheard something I said. And thought I said...
you was raped by another girl?
No, that never happened.
Joe DeRosa's all of a
sudden... I'm not lying. That never happened.
Bad about this. He started adjusting papers like an anchor man. What are you doing?
Let's straighten up this area.
Bobo, what is your brother's older than you?
That never happened. What happened was...
What happened was during
a day that he was in town, right... They misheard.
He just
something
came into town, raped his brother.
No. They misheard something I said.
During the day he was in town, he raped me, see?
What did they mishear? You got that my brother raped me? What could they have confused?
I didn't say that. I think they misheard something say that this is the first time I had seen my brother in years.
No. You said something.
They confused I was raped by my brother, something curling, with having seen him in years?
Remember when you said something happened?
Rape.
Well, they thought I said he raped me and I was in tears. They got it off like that.
No, what I said is allegedly.
Something happened.
He raped me.
I said allegedly.
But he could have, right?
Yeah, that's right.
That, I do not know if that happened.
See, you don't know.
You don't know for sure.
Your brother got you.
No, that never happened.
It might be the psych meds you're on. You're not really sure what.
I'm pretty much sure.
Your brother put his pee-pee in your hiney.
No, I'm sure that never happened.
No, you don't know.
And you're ghoulie.
I'm sure it never happened.
I thought you blew him.
No, yeah. That never happened either.
You sucked off your brother.
No, I never did.
Yes, you did.
Do you know for sure?
I never did.
Bobo, do you know for sure, though, for real?
I would know.
Would you?
No.
Would you, though?
No.
I would know.
Where you sure?
Oh, my God.
You forget a lot of it.
Jesus Christ.
I think the only
thing... Bobo just made Patrice do the Jackie Gleason Ralph Cramden.
I think there's only one thing I...
Did you see his face?
What?
There's only one thing I'm sure I've done in my sleep, and I've talked in my sleep before.
Yeah.
I've seen people try to talk.
While you were talking in your sleep, was you chewing a piece of bubble gum that wasn't quite down into bubble gum?
No, I've seen people try to...
I had a dream I was eating manicotti.
No, I said other people in my household have tried to talk to me in my sleep when they know I might not remember it.
Yeah.
Even though there have been a lot of times I have remembered.
So do you remember while you were sleeping and talking to sleep, your brother whispering in your ear, I'm raping you.
I don't think that ever happened.
What does it taste like?
You don't sound sure.
I don't even know what that tastes like.
Can we get the virus down here to Peck and Bobo?
Get that fucking virus down here.
Hey, go ahead. I don't mind people heckling me.
Oh,
I like it. Bobo is confident as fuck.
I'm telling you, he's regal with his robe and his curlingness.
You're going to wear that?
Where's your family crest? Just a fucking guy with slobber coming out of his mouth and a fucking shield.
I just realized he's
raping his brother.
A guy with a sword raping his brother.
I don't even know.
With a falcon on his arm.
He's wearing like Lady Hawk.
Falcon, a sword, and fucking Bobo. It's just,
I just realized. I kept looking at that robe going, where the fuck do I know that robe from? It's the robe that Spock wears when he comes back to life at the end of part three.
Yeah, look at you.
Your name is Opie. You were my friend.
Oh, I love Bobo.
Bobo, you got to wear that on stage tonight.
The needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few or the one.
Joe, you don't mind if he wears that tonight?
You have to fucking wear
you
that.
Have to
that's
wear
a
that
stipulation.
I have been and always will be your friend.
Jim, your name is Jim.
Bobo, actually, that's kind of funny. When I was a little kid, one of my uncles used to say I looked like Spock when I was little.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, really?
Yeah, one of my uncles used to say that because of the ears I had. I don't think they're noticeable now, but when I was little, they really looked like they stuck out.
And what did you do, cut them off like Chopper from...
No, I guess my face, somehow my face kind of grew in a way that it doesn't really, that it kind of blended in.
I can't believe I was against having him on the show at one point.
This guy is genius, man.
Yeah.
I got to see if I could dig out a really old picture of me.
Yeah, we can't wait to see that.
Actually, better yet, I'll dig out a really old picture of me. I'll dig out a picture. Wait a minute, I think I got a good one that's at home. A picture of me field next to one of the Met players from a few years ago. About 23 years ago.
All right, listen.
I'm gonna dig out a picture of a 4-year-old me.
Bobo, let me take control a little bit here. We gotta take a break. Joe DeRosa is going to be at the Stress Factory. I think everyone knows now. See what we do for you, Joe?
Thank you, buddy.
Recording a CD with Bobo. Bobo's going to warm up for Joe. Definitely in the early show. If it goes well and Joe's a little more comfortable, you might see him at the late show, too. But that's really up
and
to
we
you
wanna,
at this point,
And
Joe.
We want to see a special thanks on the CD to Bobo.
That's right.
Oh, yeah, it has to be.
So the Stress Factory, Joe DeRosa tonight and tomorrow. As he records a CD. It's very exciting for Joe. And then you got Patricia O'Neill at Bananas Comedy Club in Poughkeepsie tonight and tomorrow. Looking down the hall, I don't see the virus. I see Sam trying hard.
Sam is really preaching at that door. And where is the virus? The comedy sensation known as the virus.
Sam is working him hard, but it ain't happening.
He's trying.
All right, we'll take a break and see if Sam could talk the virus into coming in here for a quick quick thing. Get him out of retirement for 5 or 10 minutes.
A little bit.
All right. Oh, we don't have time to do this, do we?
I mean, if you want.
Bobo is starring in a new piece with Big A, Suicide versus Anger Man.
Suicide
versus Anger Man. We got the first installment here. Anger Man, played by Big A, is hurling helpless children from an orphanage window. Suicide, starring Bobo, played by Bobo, arrives to save the day.
Thank God.
Check this out as we go to break.
Coming up on the next episode of The Spectacular Suicide, the notorious villain Anger Man is hurling helpless children from the windows of the Lil Leper's orphanage to the streets below. Who can stop this deranged, diabolical, demented mastermind?
Nobody can stop me. I'm invincible. Come here, little Timmy. Would you like to see? Would you like to see if you can fly?
Come on, stupid door. I'm kicking you. Now open. Awake.
Doorknob. Stop it right there, Anger Man.
Suicide.
That's right.
Stay right where you are. Don't come any closer, or I'll throw another hopeless child to the streets below.
This ends right now, Anger Man. Leave those children alone, or I'll...
Or you'll... What?
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 What? Okay, okay, bye.
That's what I thought.
Up and away! Oh, crap, I forgot. I can't fly! Oh, my leg!
Turn statement. I'm unstoppable.
Stay tuned for another episode of The Spectacular Suicide, where Police Commissioner Vic Dumb calls upon Suicide to stop another diabolical villain.
My God, we didn't go to break because fucking Patrice is losing his fucking mind. You want to explain?
But I've never seen Bobo.
Shut up, Bobo. Shut up.
I've never seen him have an emotion other than this weird fucking autism.
Yeah.
He's in tears laughing at himself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's loving that production piece.
He had to turn his back.
He was in tears.
Yeah.
He enjoyed it very much.
You like that, Bobo?
Yeah, I thought it was freaking hilarious when I was recording that. I couldn't stop laughing just recording this because I'm imagining how it's going to sound.
Oh, we're getting behind the scenes.
Yeah, this is like fucking
stuff. I was just reading this, and I had to constantly stop myself from laughing because I'm just reading this, and I'm automatically just picturing in my head how this is all going to sound.
Who do you want to thank for that?
Well, I have to thank Derek, who probably, I'm not sure if it was Derek or whoever it was that came up with the idea.
It's Derek.
Oh, and it was Derek. I got to thank Derek for coming up with that.
Mm-hmm. Ah, look, it's like the Oscars.
Who else, do you want to thank God?
I don't do that bit, all right? I never understood that.
Called you people, a hack, you fucking prick.
I'm too much of a hack, say they thank you God, all right? How many people think that God actually watches their work?
Is that what I'm saying, Bobo?
Oh, Bobo.
That's what we call a curlinism.
That, all right?
It's like sniglets.
God's favorite team is. I noticed someone from Dallas once told me that for some reason the Cowboys stadium has like this hole in the roof because they believe that God's a Cowboys fan, so he can just watch his favorite team from up above.
But he has X-ray vision. He'd be able to see through
that shit.
So that's bullshit.
Yeah, but the thing is, they practically assume that. And the other thing I always get annoyed with...
Why are you standing like Janis Joplin?
Not to offend Cowboy fans, but... I never understood.
I think it's more Joe Cocker than
that. Let me tell you what's great too. He plows.
I always thought it was ridiculous. Yeah. They use that.
He just fucking plows.
No stopping.
I love Bobo, man. Yeah.
All right, we're gonna take a break now, Bobo. You explained the piece perfectly. Suicide versus Anger Man. Another installment, hopefully in a week or two. But that one's fucking great. Derek and the boys did a great job on that.
So we got it done. Bobo will be warming up to Joe DeRosa tonight at the Stress Factory.
At least
the early show.
Yeah.
So that's going to be fun for everybody that checks out Joe as he records his CD down there at Vinny's Place. It's a great comedy spot there.
Yeah, it's going to be fun.
And Patrice is going to be at Bananas, duh, Poughkeepsie, tonight and tomorrow. Sam says we could get the virus in here to close up the show.
I got to see this virus.
Yeah, I want
to
see this.
I was trying to explain the virus to Patrice during the break, and I don't think I did it justice.
I have to hear this legend.
It's our morning show character. He's like the mascot of the show. He's kind of retired, though, because he broke his hand because he was so mad at the bit itself. And the whole bit was him to come in and riff a little bit and tell one punchline, one joke about current events.
Did you say he broke his hand because of the bit?
Yeah, we were all confused because it worked perfectly for our needs, but he was so upset. he walked out of the studio and punched these glass walls that are pretty fucking thick.
Jesus Christ.
Now
You can do that at work? You can punch a glass wall and not get fired?
He was so upset, so mad at himself that he couldn't come up with one funny line in 20 minutes.
Now the time is, we're running out of time.
We are running out of time.
Come on, he should have get off the pot, motherfucker.
Sam said he would come in here if we really wanted him to, and he would just heckle Bobo.
Well, get in here. I want to hear some Bobo heckles.
Yeah.
Come on. run. We're running out of time.
And once again, Sam is at one of our offices just kind of pep-talking.
Sam's telling him he's got to...
I got a thumbs up from Troy Kwan.
Oh.
Which I'm is excited. Soda Kenny's personal producer when Kenny does stuff for the show. Sam is now... I got a thumbs up from Troy, so it looked like it was going down. Now Troy's back kind of trying to get him in the office.
Tell that friggin' moron to get in here.
Here comes he right.
Is he coming?
He's not happy.
All right. Here he comes.
Oh, God. He's got music in
there. I don't like this music.
Can we set up another mic real fast, or we got to work off the same one? Whatever.
I'm excited to see this. This must be awful. I watched E-Rock gladly smell Bobo's penis.
Oh, yeah,
he'd rather do that.
This has got to be... I can't wait to see what this is.
E-Rock's done a lot for our show. But...
Ladies and gentlemen, the comedy stylings. Let's bring him in. Ladies and gentlemen, let's bring him right in.
I've never seen less enthusiasm in my...
The virus, the wacky morning show funny man, we like to call him. He brings the funny.
Hi, virus.
Hi, guys.
Hey, virus.
What's going on, virus?
Not a whole lot.
It's been a while.
That it has.
So, have you been listening to Bobo?
Well, I don't know. Before we ask him that, Ant, don't you want just one fucking punchline from the virus?
Oh, no, virus, stay here.
Because the guys don't know what the virus is all about. We got Joe and Patrice in studio. Yeah. I think just to set up this properly, we get one fucking punchline from the virus.
Yeah, let's
virus, what do you got going on today?
Not a whole fucking lot. Brought in today to talk about Bobo.
He's looking down. He's mortified. Joe, ask him for a punchline.
Can I have a punchline?
Just one punchline.
Yeah, just one punchline.
Lousy punchline. Bring the funny.
One punchline, and then we can get into the Bobo thing. Patrice, you want to hear one punchline from the virus?
I would like to hear one punchline from Bobcat Virus.
Yeah, the plane. We didn't even talk about the story. The plane that overshot the runway by 150 fucking miles.
Yeah, what do you think about that, virus?
They're thinking that he might have, the pilots might have been asleep or something.
Yeah, what do you think about that?
It's the big story of the day, virus.
Yeah.
I mean, fucking Letterman and Leno and Conan, they're all going to have something on that tonight.
They'll have jokes about it.
They'll all have jokes. One punchline.
Jesus Christ. E-Rock, I do real comedy and bomb and I don't get this wound up.
Hey, Joe. It's the virus.
Virus.
Oh, sorry, the virus. It's the virus. Sorry. Excuse me, I'm sorry.
Hey, virus, what about...
We'd like the listeners to use their imagination.
Hey, virus, what about Rush Limbaugh not being able to buy a football team?
All right, there's another joke.
Oh, damn.
Joke waiting to happen. Yep. One punchline from the virus. Here it comes, one punchline.
What about it?
One punchline.
Here it comes.
The fucking music is so funny.
So what do you think about that, virus?
The virus can't look anyone in the eye right now.
No.
Because there's a lot of...
How about Lorena Bobbitt back in the news? Lorena Bobbitt's back in the news, virus.
Well, how about... All right, topical stuff, though. Patrice, you got the Yankees. They're losing. Are they going to be in the World Series? The Steve Phillips affair. Plane overshoots the runway.
Healthcare. How about the black president?
Obama won the Peace Prize.
Yeah, the Nobel Peace Prize.
Nobel Peace Prize.
Just run with one of those. Anyone.
Looking for one punchline from the virus.
Let her rip.
Before we go home for the weekend.
You know what? Let's give him the easy one from earlier that you were fucking with me about. Patrick Swayze is dead.
Patrick Swayze's dead. All right, here comes the virus. I see it. One punchline. He's going to go with one of these topics.
Come on, virus.
And he doesn't understand how great this is. He gets so mad. One punchline. Go ahead, virus. We haven't heard from you. One punchline.
Come on, virus.
Here it comes.
Perhaps it wasn't made clear that this is not the virus's strong suit.
Well, virus.
How about New York City Cavs, virus? What's going on with them?
Yeah. What's up with that?
Just riff, off the cuff. What do you got? New York City Cavs.
You got it. Come on.
Here comes the punchline. And go. We're all waiting for the punchline.
Come on.
Osama Bin Laden, they can't find him. They can't find the guy.
That's right. They still haven't found him, have they?
They still haven't found the guy.
Still haven't
found him.
Come on, virus.
What do you got, virus?
They paid George Bush $7 million to write a book, virus.
Damn.
Can you believe it?
For a pop-up book?
There you go.
I liked it. Oh,
thank you.
Hey, Windows 7 launches today, right? Is that today?
That's correct.
Yeah, what about Windows 7?
Gave you a lot of topics, Virus.
You got to pay for another fucking Windows?
Yeah.
They just had Vista.
It's the replacement for Vista, because Vista was all fucked up.
Yeah, Vista was all mad. Ass.
So they rushed another one.
Why are we having a real break? Who gives a shit?
What do you think of
Virus? One punchline.
Windows Vista sucked. This girl walking by is pretty hot.
All right, maybe we're confusing them. Let's all shut up and hear the Virus. The comedy stylings of the Virus.
Let's all agree on one thing he's supposed to be thinking about, though.
Come on.
I say the big story with this plane going 150 miles past the airport, it had to turn fucking around because
the
pilots might have been sleeping.
What do you think about that?
I'm sure the late night talk shows are going to be all over that one. Let the Virus do one on that. Here we go.
Did you hear about these pilots on this plane?
The goddamn plane for 150 miles past the airport.
That's all something. Come on, they'll all have something.
We're letting him off the hook, though. We're all talking, which means he doesn't have to perform. Yeah. Virus, go ahead. We're all going to show him now.
Go. Plane, go.
Punch that.
But we're live.
I got that. Here it comes. I see it. You can see it. All right, go. There you go. Just try something.
I got nothing.
See, you appreciate this, right?
It's great.
All right, go.
Bobo, do you have anything about the plane?
Oh, shit, here we go.
Now I got a good one.
All right.
That's probably one of the same people that probably couldn't land a plane in that Top Gun video game on the NES.
Bobo showing up the Virus.
Fucking Bobo.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, he's got another one.
And I got another good one about this Nobel Peace Prize. Amazing. This guy wins an award and does less stuff than Black Earl.
Oh, that is some fucking stuff.
All right, back to the Virus. One punchline from the Virus.
Back to the Virus.
See, here we go. See how easy it is? Go ahead, Virus.
Virus, airplane.
Airplane, go.
One line.
One punchline. That's all we ask. Not asking for much. Just one punchline. Here it comes. Oh, we almost had it.
Oh, I thought I...
Yeah, I think he has it. Go ahead. Just go with it. What the hell?
Whatever was in your head, whatever popped in. Two pilots, maybe sleeping on the plane. Passengers...
Come on, I got an even better one.
Let's go.
This guy probably overshot the runway because he was getting a Hummer while landing the plane.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, somebody was sucking his dick. Got a million of them.
Go ahead, Virus.
Virus, plane.
You can't be showed up by Bobo.
Guys, airplane.
I love Daniel Curlin.
He's the best.
You get to go home if you get one punchline out.
Plane. Pilots.
Overshot the runway.
Airlines miles. Ripping everybody off.
Yeah.
Things that happen on a plane.
For the money they charge.
Stakes on a plane. Anything on a plane.
Anything.
Fucking anything.
Ducks flying in the engine. Crash the plane. Yeah.
Every new comic has plane material. Jesus. Let's go. Here comes the Virus. I see it. Just let him do his thing.
What about?
Here we go.
Sky Chef. Ambien.
That is with the prices they charge. Yeah, set them up.
Just
with
go.
With the prices they charge, you figure.
Yeah, just go.
Fill in the blank.
Virus, have just a joke about something that you think is plain.
Yeah, not even that. Or about something that makes wood flat. A plane.
Bobo's
it can be any type of plane.
Yeah, Bobo's frustrated because I know he's got another one just Ready to go.
You got another one, Bobo?
I think I got another one in the plane. I bet you he got too frightened by probably these kids that imitate that scene in the Beavis and Butthead movie. That scene when the guy goes, I am Gloria. I need more TV for my bunhole.
Jeez, I'm going to get at the Stress Factory for Bobo tonight.
Yes.
All right, Virus, come on. We go home.
Canceling my show to come see Bobo.
I think I want Virus on it, too.
Yeah, Virus is just standing there sweating.
Yeah, during the check spot.
Virus, one line. Let's go. One lousy line.
Virus has no material on any of this.
Yeah, but you got to think on your feet.
Do you have any material on anything, Virus?
No.
Virus, you want to work the crowd? Like
hey, Bobo.
Did?
I know what we need to do. But we'll make fun of the Virus for not having a punchline.
Yeah, go ahead.
Come on, what is it, Virus? Are you functioning on Windows Vista? I got a good one about Windows Vista.
Yeah. Okay, go ahead.
We'll take it.
Looks like my uncle's going to end up having another operating system to get frustrated about. My uncle's the guy that doesn't know that you don't need to read all the legal notices when you download something. He says, I spent almost an hour and a half reading the legal notices, and I says, nobody reads the legal notices. You can just skip that part.
That's actually fucking funny.
I just went and I said, I'm great. I'll sacrifice.
Are you reading the fucking legal? Stupid motherfucker.
Before you click accept,
he's
just like,
fucking
I told him, great. I could simplify it for you.
Hold the fuck up. Hold on, Bubba. What the fuck is Virus doing?
Virus, let's go.
Come on, Virus. He's tearing you an asshole.
He said Virus is operating on Windows. and then moved along to that the was, fucking uncle.
That was a beautiful callback. That was beautiful, perfect. Bobo.
Virus, perfect. Don't let fucking Bobo heckle. Yeah, at least fucking heckle back.
Virus? This music is unbelievably perfect.
It's great. It's fucking great.
I'm not tired of it either. I've got to fucking buy it now.
Yeah, I love it.
Let's go, Virus.
I love it.
Virus,
to you. One punchline.
Bobo drank two giant cans of Monster. Three of the Monster energy drinks? Yeah. Fuck me, man.
I got another one.
All right.
This is an illegal operation. You'll be shut down. Your computer will shut down in 5 seconds.
All right. Oh, that.
You know what I'm talking about. Those things that pop up that knock you offline.
I love
that
it.
That don't make sense.
He literally was just like, you saw this thing that happens sometimes, right?
Hey, it's better than what the Virus is giving us. Come on, Virus. One punch
you
line.
You saw this thing that happens sometimes.
Come on, Virus.
Virus.
One fucking punch line. It's getting late.
Anything about computers or technology?
Computers.
Anything.
The plane story. Obama, Nobel Peace Prize.
Yankees.
Philly. Baseball.
Bobo.
Comic-Con. Anything. One lousy punchline. Ooh, a light just went on in his head. Here it is.
Here it comes.
He's ready to try one. I can see it.
Bubbles disgusted with him, and I am too.
Yeah. This is not trying.
Bubbles hiking his robe up.
Oh, he's done with it. Bubbles done with him.
He's clenching his fist.
Bubble, give him another fucking insult to kickstart him.
Yeah, insult the Virus.
Come on, Virus. What the heck are you doing? Are you doing what I just said my uncle does? I'm just going to say to you what I always say to my uncle when he thinks he has to read the legal notices. He says, Uncle Ray, I'll simplify it for you. Basically, it's saying, if you try copying this program and selling it, the FBI is going to be all over your ass.
Virus.
There it is, virus.
Virus.
Virus, the FBI is going to be all over your ass. What do you got to say about that?
I'm losing to a retard with 48 dick surgeries.
Actually, specifically a quarter retard.
Oh, God damn. He just ripped apart your mediocre insult with a devastatingly better insult about himself.
And he turned it on himself, too, a little bit.
So it's nothing you can do.
Beautiful comeback.
It's nothing you can do but go. There's nothing he can do but go, oh, yeah?
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Bubba literally went, I'm a quarter retarded. What?
What now, bitch?
All he left him, all he left,
now,
all he left him was, oh, I didn't know.
Jesus Christ. Oh, my God almighty.
People want to know what Virus is doing. He hasn't looked anyone in the eye the entire time. He's just staring at the ground.
My God.
What is it, Virus? Your stomach's growling?
My God.
Jesus Christ.
My God. Virus? E-Rock? Anything? You're going to let this guy fucking get the upper hand?
What the fuck is this world coming to?
Yeah.
No? All right, good. Music's back.
All right, Virus. That's your cue. That's your cue, Virus. Come on now.
All right, come on.
Oh, shit.
Leave us with one punchline.
Come on.
Virus doesn't have any punchlines.
Come on, you're Virus. You got
Maybe Virus
something.
Should go watch Police Academy 3 again to get his...
Virus had a lot of time to prepare.
Yeah, Virus. To reestablish his character.
Police Academy 3, One Crazy Summer.
Shakes the Clown.
Why don't you burn a couch?
When the sign at White Castle says open 24 hours, are they talking about the restaurant or your stomach?
That's from a quarter of a retard. He's fucking flying through, man.
You're taking fat jokes from Bobo. You're insane.
Well, the intelligence part didn't get affected.
That's what he's saying. A couple of his motor skills, but not the fucking car, baby. It's run smooth down the highway, bitch.
I like Bobo. Bobo's got balls. You got balls, kid. Man. I like it.
Man.
I like it.
Man. See?
So.
And Virus? Finally, Virus.
Here it is. We end.
We don't want this 20 minutes to be a complete waste of time. At least finish up with a punchline.
Come on, finish up.
One punchline.
Here we go. Here we go. Come on, time's ticking.
Hey, I just heard that John Corside was reprimanding you for eating while driving.
Some of these I'm really laughing at. Because it's fucking good. It's fucking God fucking
thing. I'm just making fat jokes from Bobo.
Bobo's a fat joke machine.
You can't take fat jokes from Bobo.
Come on, Virus. You gotta
come on, let's go.
Come back at him.
Come on, Windows Vista. That's the best.
Windows Fat Windows Vista.
Fat Windows Vista. You fat fucking operating system.
I just found out that in the third Transformers movie, they based the character on you, Optimus Prime Rib.
Daniel Curlin is exploding on the scene, ladies and gentlemen.
Holy shit.
Remember the day when you heard Bobo?
Oh, man.
I mean, Virus is taking fat jokes from Bobo.
Virus, come on. Optimus Prime Rib.
That was beautiful.
Damn, that's funny.
That was beautiful.
You fat fucking robot.
Everyone else is doing their own Virus fat jokes. Out from Jersey. Now, the Virus is so fat he's got dollars in one pocket and yen in the other.
Now I got a better good one.
Oh, shit.
Actually, you know what
Jesus Christ. Oh, my God. That's fucking good.
If they put, I'm not sure how many people are old enough to remember this, but if they put Grimlock in Transformers 3, maybe E-Rock should do the voice of Grimlock.
Yeah! Hey, Grimlock! Hey, Grimlock and Prime Rib!
Hey. Fat dinosaur robot.
Hey.
Come on, Virus. Virus.
Optimus Prime.
Don't let us down here, Virus.
Optimus Prime Rib is brutal.
Windows Prime Rib. Oh. There you go.
That is brutal.
Oh, that's fucking great.
What do you say, Jesus Christ. Virus? Close this out with one punchline. Make fun of Bobo. I don't give a shit. Give us one.
He already did it. Bobo just turned it back on himself and just went with another joke.
Can Virus do crowd work on Bobo?
I don't know what he can do.
That's the problem.
The jerk store called and they're all out of you.
All right, Virus, here we go.
Uh-huh. This Odd Couple music is great.
This music can't get better.
Perfect fit.
Here comes the punchline.
Come on, Virus.
He's got
one fucking barb. Throw it at him.
What do you do for a living? Just say that.
Do you have any concept of time going by? Or is this like, has this been 2 seconds for you?
I'm not sure. You can imagine if he was in the hatch from season 2 of Lost, I think he'd be busy eating, that the whole hatch would explode on him.
There you go!
Another.
There you go!
He went from fat Windows to fat robot to fat Lost. Just fat jokes. Just fat jokes.
He went from computer. He went through all the entertainment shit.
Everything.
Computers, movies, television.
He's all over. It's all over the place. There's no stopping him.
Come on, Virus. One punchline.
What an arsenal he has.
Then we give the plugs and get the fuck out of here, and we get to all enjoy our weekend.
Come on. It's fucking 30 seconds, and it's gonna be.
It's gonna be Ron and Fez time. Let's go.
You gotta hit him with something.
Hit him hard, right now.
So what is it? Are you eating the Oreo Kermit logo on them?
Bobo's Daniel Kirkland smashing him in his curling. Daniel Bobo Kirkland is smashing virus.
I do have to admit, though, I would love that if they made Dharma food products.
Okay.
If they actually sold them at the supermarket. I want to see somewhere in the supermarket at some point a box of Dharma cornflakes.
Now, Virus, I would take what he just said and say something about it.
Yeah,
because you know that was nonsense. He wants to see Dharma food in the supermarket. Smash him on that.
Come on, Prime Rib.
Every time there's awkward silence, it's right when that melody jumps to the high octave, and it's so fucking funny, dude.
Yes.
Come on, Virus. Leave us with a punchline.
Come on, Virus. Oh, my God.
It'd be a great closer.
Oh, this is so frustrating.
It's so frustrating.
It's so
for everybody.
Fucking frustrating.
One punchline. Come on.
Me, like me Grimlock. Me can't come up with any jokes.
Oh, shit.
I got no jokes.
Bobo's into character work now.
Oh, fucking Bobo is turning into fucking Richard Carlin.
He's destroyed. He's destroying Virus.
Oh. Bobo George Carlin. Curlin.
Bobo Curlin. Look at Bobo's hips are starting to hurt. He has to go. He has to sit.
Yeah.
I was trying to hold this up so I don't slip on it. So I don't trip.
All right.
That's all I was doing, holding this up so I
don't
trip.
All right. Don't worry.
All right. Come on. Now we're officially into Ron and Fez time. Yeah. So
I got another one. Is this why I got a... Is this why too many people have to wait too long at the voting booth?
Because of dumb Prime Rib over here.
Come on.
You're holding us up at the voting booth.
Come on.
Just say one thing. You got something for
fucking thing.
Just make a retard joke.
Stupid.
Sam goes, you're stupid. Just go with that. Hey, you're stupid.
I don't think he has the ability to even watch funny things. Like, like this is not even the concept of funny is not even here.
No.
Right. Bobo is killing.
That's it. And we're both going to bomb tonight. We are both going to bomb tonight after this whole experience. That's it.
Not me, nigga.
The virus can't talk because his mouth is full.
Oh, he's killing us.
What's it full of, Bobo? What's it full of?
No, probably full of what he ate for breakfast.
He still hasn't finished chewing.
Hours later.
Prime rib. Transform.
Prime rib. Holy shit.
Anything, virus? I just want to hear the virus voice again. We only get to hear it every 5 minutes. Go ahead, virus.
You got this.
You got this.
This is going to suck. No, go ahead. Yeah. I have confidence.
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 Knock him out of the park.
Hit it.
The virus only has one retard joke.
Okay.
You're looking at it.
Scott, here it is.
One here, it comes. Here it comes.
Finally, we can go home. Start our weekends. Here comes the virus. And go.
Come on.
Come on.
Bubba's laughing at him.
I know. Come on, virus.
Come on, you said you had one.
Let's go, just do it.
But what do you think? You're starting to act like my cousin's car after he let the car ran out of gas before he filled it.
Oh, you're a fucking... You need OnStar, nigga.
which happens a lot. But wait till the very last minute to fill his car. He'll wait till the last minute to get gas, my cousin.
Wait, we all forgot that the virus did have a punchline.
Go ahead. Yeah.
Let's go. One retard show. Just look down at the floor and do it.
You said he only had one retard joke. Yeah. What is it?
How would you make Bobo commit suicide?
How?
How?
Put a knife in his hand and ask him who's special.
All right, listen, we're going to just go home. Joe DeRosa is going to be at the Stress Factory tonight and tomorrow recording his comedy CD. Bobo will be opening up for the early show. And Patrice has already walked out of the studio. You can see Patrice at Bananas Comedy Club in Poughkeepsie tonight and tomorrow. Have a good week.
Thank you.